Hello all, I welcome you all to this session of basic thermodynamics. So in the last class we were talking about ideal gases. In today's class we will discuss about real gases, van der Waals equation, and we will solve few problems on the same. So if you recall, we had defined ideal gases. So we are talking about the module 5, ideal gases and real gases. So how did we define ideal gases? The gas which obeys the law, that is the product of pressure and volume, is equal to product of mass, characteristic gas constant and temperature. Then those gases which obeys ideal gas equation at all temperature and pressure, those gases were identified as ideal gases, where P is the pressure in Newton per meter square, V is the volume in meter cube, mass is in kg, and R is characteristic gas constant in joule per kg Kelvin, where T is the temperature in absolute scale, that is temperature must be in Kelvin. So if you look at the unit, it is balanced, that is if you cancel meter square and meter square, you have Newton meter. Newton meter is nothing but joule, then kg kg gets cancelled and Kelvin Kelvin gets cancelled, this is also joules. So this is the one which is known as ideal gas equation, which is PV is equal to MRT. And we have also learnt that this equation can be written in different forms. It can be like, for example, what I will do, I will send the mass to the other side, I will send the mass to this side, it will be V by M is equal to RT. What is this? Volume by mass, which we call it as specific volume, so is equal to RT. Okay. Now this once again, if you balance it out, it must balance. Volume will be meter cube per kg. Now R is in joule per kg Kelvin, characteristic gas constant, this is in Kelvin, gets cancelled, joule per kg, meter square get cancelled, Newton meter per kg is once again joule per kg. Now this is one more equation of this ideal gas equation. So ideal gas equation can be written even in this format. Now this can further be reduced to, like, I will start from here, this is just mass is sent to the denominator this side, I am starting from here, PV is equal to RT. Now you can write R as R bar by M, where R is the characteristic gas constant given by universal gas constant R bar by molecular weight. So this can be written as R bar into M. Now I will send the molecular weight to this side, V into M is equal to R bar T. Now what is this? This is called as molar volume. So molar volume is nothing but specific volume into molecular weight, where specific volume unit we had just derived here, it was meter cube per kg, and we know the unit of molecular weight, which is kg per kg mole. Now what will be the unit of molar volume, which is denoted as V bar? V bar is nothing but molar volume. V bar, small V bar is molar volume. Now this is meter cube per kg mole. Unit of V bar is meter cube per kg mole. I will substitute that here. V into M is given by V bar, which is molar volume, is equal to R bar T, where unit here is Newton per meter square. Molar volume unit is meter cube per kg mole. R bar unit joule per kg mole Kelvin, temperature is in Kelvin. So Kelvin, Kelvin gets cancelled. This side you have joule per kg mole. Here also you have Newton meter by kg mole, which is nothing but joule per kg mole. The unit is balanced. So what is important to note here is this equation can also be written in the form of P V bar is equal to R bar T. Or you can go for one more form. I will start from here. PV is equal to M R T. Now mass can be written as number of kg moles into molecular weight into R T. Or R can also be written as R bar by M. Mass will be equal to number of kg moles into molecular weight, which gives us the mass. R we know is given by universal gas constant by molecular weight. If you cancel this out, what we will have is PV is equal to N R bar T. Now these are the forms of ideal gas equation which we already know. That is PV is equal to MRT is one form, or you can also write it just by sending this to the denominator. You have P small v is equal to RT, where small v is specific volume. Or it can also be written in this format, P V bar is equal to R bar T, where V bar is molar volume, which is small v, that is specific volume into molecular weight. R is the universal gas constant. And this can also be written in this format, where P is pressure, V is volume, N is number of kg moles, and R bar is universal gas constant and temperature. If you want the unit, Newton meter square, volume is in meter cube. So you should get Newton meter, which is joule. So N is number of kg moles, R bar is given by joule per kg mole Kelvin. Temperature is in Kelvin, kg moles get cancelled, Kelvin, Kelvin get cancelled, you will have joule unit on the other side also. Now this can be represented in any of these forms which we know. Now what we assumed while saying that the PV, that is the product of pressure and volume, is equal to mass, the product of mass, R and temperature, we had made few assumptions. The assumptions were, assumptions made during ideal or in ideal gas equation are, there is no intermolecular forces. There is no intermolecular forces. So we had neglected the intermolecular forces, and volume of the molecule also we had not considered. Volume of the molecules are neglected. So we had not considered while writing this equation, or this does not take into account the intermolecular forces between the molecules and the volume of the molecules. Now we will have to modify this equation for the real gases. That means real gases will have these two. That means intermolecular forces will be there and the volume of the molecules will be there. You cannot neglect them. So if you modify this equation to suit or to overcome those disadvantages which we had, that is which we did not consider the forces as well as the volume of molecules, if you consider that, this equation becomes real gas equation. That means this equation has to be modified so that it takes into account the forces, that is intermolecular forces, and the volume of the molecules. So that equation will start it from here. That is, this equation is called as van der Waals equation. So real gases will have intermolecular forces and volume of molecules has to be considered. That is P plus A by V bar square into V bar square minus B is equal to R bar T. Now, sorry, this is just V bar. Now, this is what we call it as van der Waals equation or real gas equation. Those gases which are real follow van der Waals equation. Now, if you forget about the terms, that is, if there is no A by V bar square and B, this is still the same equation. That means, if you neglect this term and this term, it is still an ideal gas equation. That is, P V bar is equal to R bar T. That means, what we are trying to understand here is, the term A by V bar square and the term B is a correction factor which takes into account these two factors. That means, the term A by V bar square is the correction factor which considers intermolecular forces. The term B is the correction factor which takes into account the volume. Correction factor which considers the volume of molecules. So, this is the equation which we should know, that is van der Waals equation or real gas equation, which is given by P plus A by V bar square multiplied by V bar minus B must be equal to R bar times temperature. Now, we will try to discuss the units associated with this. I mean, what should be the unit of A? What should be the unit of this? We know what should be the unit of B. By the way, A and B are constant. A and B are constant. It differs for different gases. So, that value is already there in our data handbook, which we will copy it from there. Then, we will try to solve the problems. Now, we will discuss what? The units of A and B. Now, if you look at here, what we have? Pressure is in Newton per meter square. So, if you are adding something to this term, this also has to be in the same unit. But we already know what? The unit of V bar square. That means, if you solve the units of this A by V bar square, it should be what? Newton per meter square, because you are adding that term to pressure. So, keep that in mind. If you solve the units of this, this must be equal to Newton per meter square. We already know the unit of V bar. The unit of V bar was meter cube per kg mole. So, meter cube per kg mole. Okay. Now, that is meter cube per kg mole. This is meter cube per kg mole. Then, the unit of A must be, this is V bar square. So, this, if you square it, meter power 6 kg mole power square. Okay. Now, A must be what? Here you should get Newton. So, Newton. Then, what you should get? Newton per meter square, right? Then, here if you have meter power 4, then you will have meter square. So, 4 gets cancelled. You will remain with meter power 2. Then, kg mole square should also get cancelled out. So, I will say, if you have this, kg mole square get cancelled out. Meter power 4 will cancel with meter power 4. You will remain with meter power 2. Now, you will have Newton per meter square. That means, the unit of A must be Newton meter power 4 by kg mole square. The unit of A must be Newton meter power 4 by kg mole square. So, by the way, in the data handbook, it is given in kilo Newton meter power 4. Be careful while copying But whenever you are using it here, it has to be in what? Newton meter. So, multiply it by 10 power 3 in order to keep it in Newton meter 4. So, whenever you are copying from the data handbook, try to keep it in Newton meter 4. That means, multiply it with 10 power 3 and keep it in this unit, Newton meter 4 by kg mole power square. Now, this is quite simple. So, this is the first term. You have Newton power meter square, Newton by meter square, Newton by meter square. Now, you have V bar in meter cube per kg mole. So, obviously, if you are subtracting this from, B from this term, this also has to be in the same unit. The unit of B must be meter cube per kg mole. So, unit of B must be meter cube per kg mole. Okay. Now, you have the other side, you know, joule per kg mole Kelvin, temperature in Kelvin, Kelvin get cancelled out. You should have joule per kg mole. If you substitute here, you have the first term Newton per meter square, second term meter cube per kg mole. What you will have is Newton meter per kg mole, which is nothing but joule per kg mole. So, what we need to understand here is Van der Waals equation is the modified form of ideal gas equation, which considers the intermolecular forces and the volume of molecules, which we have neglected in ideal gas equation. And the value of A and the value of B must be copied from the data handbook, which is already there. And A is a constant, B is a constant. The value of A and B are different for different gases. Then the unit of A, while substituting it from the data handbook, must be in Newton meter power 4. But in the data handbook, it is given in kilo Newton meter power 4 by kg mole square. Be careful, multiply it with 10 power 3 while substituting it to here. And the volume, the unit of B is in meter cube per kg mole itself in the data handbook. Just copy it to here. Then you will have to find out any of the term here which we can find out. Now, we will move on to the problems on the same. Okay, we will solve a problem on the ideal and real gases which we have discussed. So, before that, we have discussed Van der Waals gas equation and we had talked about the values of A and B. Now, know that these values are already tabulated in the data handbook. The data handbook which we are referring here is Thermodynamic Data Handbook by B.T. Nijaguna. Thermodynamic Data Handbook by B.T. Nijaguna. So, in that you have these values as well as the formula is also there. The Van der Waals equation is in page number 59 and the values of A and B for different gases is also tabulated in table C8, which is table C8, which is also there in page number 59. And if you want the molecular weight, if not given in the problem, molecular weight of different gases is also there in the page number 61 of the data handbook B.T. Nijaguna. Now, we will move with the problem. Determine the pressure exerted by 1 kg of carbon dioxide. So, he is talking about determine the pressure exerted by 1 kg of carbon dioxide. So, mass is 1 kg. The fluid which we are talking about is CO2, okay, at 100 degrees Celsius. So, temperature is given. Remember, in this equation, the temperature must be in absolute scale. I will convert this into Kelvin as soon as I see the temperature. So, this must be 373 Kelvin while substituting it into whether ideal gas equation or in real gas equation or Van der Waals equation. Now, he is saying by using Van der Waals equation, that means determine the pressure exerted by 1 kg of CO2 at 100 degree centigrade by Van der Waals equation, the specific volume is 1 m³/kg. Specific volume is denoted by small v. The molecular mass is given. If not given, I will go to page number 61. Given. So molecular weight of CO2 is given, which is 44. He has not given the unit. The unit must be kg per kg mole. Now compare the result obtained. If CO2 is treated as an ideal gas, that means you have to calculate the pressure considering van der Waals equation and also considering the ideal gas equation. That means you must calculate P by van der Waals equation, also by ideal gas equation. We will go with the first, that is first we will consider calculating the pressure by using van der Waals equation. You can copy the van der Waals equation from page number 59. It is there. P plus A by V bar square into V bar minus B must be equal to R bar T. Okay. Now this must be known to you, or you can copy it from here, page number 59. So unit must be known to you. Now what is the only unknown? The pressure must be the only unknown in Newton per meter square. The unit we already have discussed. A must be in Newton per meter square. If you are adding this with this term, this also must be in Newton per meter square. We know that V bar is meter cube per kg mole. You are squaring it, so this will be meter power 6 and this will be kg mole per square. Then A must be Newton meter power 4 by kg mole square. So that after cancellation, you will remain with Newton per meter square. That means A must be Newton meter power 4 by kg mole square. Now the value of A, you can copy it. The value of A, from data handbook, that is page number 59, table C8, for what? CO2. For CO2, the value of A must be copied, which is 365.6 kilonewton meter power 4 by kg mole square. That means the unit what he has given in data handbook is kilonewton. So what I will do, I will keep it in Newton meter power 4 by kg mole square. Okay. Now A value we have got. Now V bar unit must be meter cube per kg mole. Minus B value must also be in meter cube per kg mole. So B value in meter cube per kg mole. Once again, where do we copy it from? From data handbook. Page number 59, table C8. B value for CO2. So B value is given, which is 0.0428 meter cube per kg mole. So these are already tabulated. No need to worry about the unit. It is in the same required unit. Now R bar must be joule per kg mole Kelvin. Temperature is in Kelvin. Joule per kg mole is the unit. Here also you will remain with, if you solve this, Newton per meter square and meter cube per kg mole, what you will get? Newton meter per kg mole, which is nothing but joule per kg mole. Now we will substitute it. What we have? We are trying to find out the value of pressure. So that I will keep it as it is. The value of A, which is 365.6 into 10 power 3 divided by V bar. So V bar value, which we did not have, V bar is nothing but specific volume into molecular weight. So small v value is already given to us, which is 1. Molecular weight value for CO2 is 44, so v bar will be 44 meter cube per kg mole. So if you look at the unit, meter cube per kg, molecular weight is kg per kg mole. So you will have the unit meter cube per kg mole. So v bar is 44 meter cube per kg mole. So v bar square, 44 square into v bar, 44 minus the value of b, 0.0428 must be equal to, the value of r is a universal gas constant r bar, which is nothing but 8314 joule per kg mole Kelvin. So this must be known to us, the value of r bar, 8314 joule per kg mole Kelvin. Temperature is 373 Kelvin. Now if you solve this, the only unknown we have in this equation is P. Solve for pressure. You must get the pressure in the units which we were supposed to substitute, that is Newton per meter square. So we have got the pressure as 70.36 into 10 power 3. This can be written as 70.36 into 10 power 3 Newton per meter square, or 70.36 kilopascals, where pascals means Newton per meter square. If you divide by 1000, it will be kilopascals, kilopascals. Now, this is first question. Now, what he is also asking, compare the results obtained. If CO2 is treated as an ideal gas, we know the ideal gas equation is equal to PV is equal to MRT. Now, what I will try to do, I will try to keep it simple. Whatever the values we have, with that values, I will try to do it. So, pressure, you can write PV by M is equal to RT. This can be written as PV bar. R can be written as R bar by M into temperature. Now I will substitute, this is specific volume. If you multiply this with this, P V into molecular weight, which will be V bar R bar T. So this is one more ideal gas equation which you can use. You can use this equation as well and try to calculate the pressure. Now what we should have is, you should once again calculate the value of R. Okay, then you should have calculated the volume. So the values which I have is the molar volume and the universal gas constant. I will try to keep this equation in this form so that my calculation become simple. So pressure is the only unknown. Molar volume we have calculated, which is 44. R bar value we know, 8314. Temperature we know, 373 Kelvin. Now the value of pressure, you should get it in Newton per meter square. We are going to get the answer in Newton per meter square, which is 70.48 into 10 power 3 Newton per meter square. Or it can be written as 70.48 kilopascal. Now what we have done? We have calculated pressure of CO2 if it is at certain temperature and certain specific volume. Then what will be its pressure if you consider it as a real gas, and also if you consider it as a ideal gas.